young preacher. 25 years ago this month, I was, not this month, but this year, 25 years ago, in October, I was thrown out of my church. No, it wasn't nothing scandalous, but they asked me to leave. Had to go. But what had happened is, I didn't see the larger map of things. Because in March of 87, I was hit with papers of 18 allegations on why they wanted me to leave. All I was trying to do, y'all, was lead the church forward. That's all I was trying to do. But they didn't like my beard. They didn't like my, that's how crazy it got. They didn't like none of that kind of stuff. And I mean nothing, y'all. Pastor got a beard, I'm sorry. But they didn't like mine. I was much younger then, and I wasn't trying to create anything. All I was trying to do in this neighborhood was to reach people for Jesus. That's all I was trying to do, nothing else. And one night, September of that year, 87, we had a big church meeting. And this was what our church meeting came down to. And I quote, "We didn't call you here," they stood up, "to bring all these other people in our church." Well, I told them I didn't know it was y'all church, but I later found out it was their church. And I really don't want to be the pastor of nobody's church where the people own the church. I want the church where Jesus is the Lord of the church. And really, they told me, "You got to go." Now, at the same time that they were telling me I needed to leave, 87 miles east of Houston in Beaumont, Texas, a church had invited me to preach. And while they were asking me to leave, they had called me as the pastor elect. And I wanted to go because I knew down in Little Beaumont, I could just go and have my way. And so I was on my way to Beaumont. But now my intentions were, because I'd worked out a major deal to get paid, because I was trained and I was going to get paid. I was only going to pastor for 2-3 years, leave and go do a PhD and go teach. So I was going to use the church as a stepping stone to do something else. But I've lived long enough that anytime you walk away from the church, you ain't stepping up. You stepping down. So the church called me. And then would you not know, at the same time, that Greater Mount Zion was saying, "Leave." Starlight was saying, "Come." 32 people were saying, "Over here." And I said, "Wait a minute, Lord. I didn't sign up for no 32 people. This church in Beaumont, it might be a little town, but it got the biggest church and the biggest membership and a new building, and I'm going over there." And that God did something. At the right place, he put the right people at the right time to say, "You're going in the wrong direction." 25 years later, I'm going to say, "Lord, thank you that I didn't make the wrong turn at the wrong place with the wrong people." I wish I had company the other night. God can lead you, and God has a divine timing. Now, I don't know who I'm talking to tonight, but I guarantee you, you got this many people in here. Somebody has been standing in the middle of making a decision, and you've been waiting on God, and the Lord has put the right people at the right place, at the right time, to say, "Don't you dare go left when I've been telling you to go right." I don't care how good left looks, you better go right. I don't care how good left feels, you better go right. Preach, Ralph West.